I'd like to meet the man who created that tune. It's a cracker, it's in March, I think. Yeah, The Rose in the Gap. Yeah, now, there's some of my songs do require a certain degree of explanation, so you'll just have to bear with me just for a moment, but I own, very fortunate to own, a lovely old yacht that was built in 1909 in Burnham on Crouch, and I rescued it as a restoration project that was due to be sawn up, and it's a lovely boat and deserves to live on, and it does. And during my researches into the history of this boat, because when you own something like that, it's not just a boat, it's everything that goes with it. And the story I discovered on the internet, the wonderful internet, one day this person posted a photograph of the yard where the boat was built at Burnham on Crouch. Ranged along the front of the building as a group of workmen at exactly the time when my boat was built, 1909, with another boat, not my boat, but the poignancy of this is that there was a young man there in his very early 20s that had apprenticed at the boatyard at the time when my boat was built, so he must have, without any shadow of a doubt, his hands helped create this wonderful boat of mine. His name was John Wight, and he sadly went off, as did thousands and thousands of other people, to the trenches where he died right at the end of the war. And I just thought that is a fantastic thing to know about this boat. And when I'm sailing it, I kind of think that young man, his hands have been on the timber and he helped to create that. And I like to think that he lives on in the fabric of this yacht. And this is a song which it is a sad song, but that's just the way it is. It can't be anything else. And I've called it the Burnham Yacht Builders, and this is it, and we hope you like it. Not every single one of my songs is sad, but this is a bit of a beast. Sorry.
Life's tales dying. And you